Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be doing an in-depth smoky eye look. I'm going to take you step by step how to create a smoky eye. Today I'm going to be using the Gosh palette with these beautiful neutrals in. The pigment is absolutely amazing. I'm going to be using different brushes, and I'm going to show you different techniques you can use using those brushes. Okay, we're going to start with the base color. I'm going to go into this beautiful soft pink color over here as my base, and I'm going to be using this brush over here. It's just a flat brush. I really like this brush because it really helps me define the shape of my eye and what shape I want to use for my eyeshadow. These pigments are really divine, so I'm just going to go in and I'm just going to tap that in with my brush, just using tapping motions, just to get the shape that I want. If you want to see how I apply my foundation, you can go onto one of my previous videos and have a look at that, but today we are just going to focus on an eye look. So I'm just doing swishy motions and tapping motions gently, just to get the shape I want. I'm going with quite a winged out look. It's one of my favorite looks to do. Very, very nice pigment, guys. I really, really am happy with this palette. The one thing that I'm not too happy about is the colors go into each other when you use it. Like, there's a lot of fallout on the palette, and they're also not indented into the palette. Like, everything's just sitting like on top of the palette, so it's easy for those colors to mix, which I'm not really happy about. Okay, so I'm just, you can see here, getting that shape, and I'm just gonna be working my way just underneath my brow bone. Just blending outwards. Like I said in a previous video, the more you blend, I feel the better it will become. And remember, eyeshadow is buildable, so don't go in with a dark color at first. Rather go in with a lighter color first, work that out, and then build darker and darker. You know, it's easier to do. Like, if you make a mistake and you have a darker color, it's going to be harder to correct that mistake than with a lighter color. Okay, so I'm just smudging those lines, gently softening those edges. Making it more subtle. Just using upward circular motions on the edge. Then I'm going to take a clean brush, and I'm just going to go in with this lighter shade over here, and I'm just going to soften those edges a bit more. Just gently, not even touching the eye, just doing gentle back and forth motions, just to soften out those edges even more. And as you can see, as you blend outwards and use those gentle motions, the edges just get softer and softer. Okay, then I'm going to go into a darker color in my crease. And I'm going to be using an angled flat brush, and I'm going to go in with this purpley color over there. And I'm just going to go into my crease with that color, just to give this eye look some more definition. Oh, I really like these colors. Very nice colors for winter. Get into that corner there. Okay. I'm then gonna take a smaller brush, this one over here, and I'm going to go into an even darker color, and I'm gonna be going into that one over there, and I'm just going to use that on the outer V of my eye. Just putting it in that little crease there and blending it outward. Just that last little bit on my outer eye, and just blending that up. Took a long time for me to say. Okay, just gonna blend that a little bit more. I'm then gonna take the same brush that I first used and just go back into that first color, and I'm just going to add a little bit more color back into there. I feel that it's a little bit, and then the second color. Okay, just want to blend these edges out a bit more. Okay, I'm then going to cut my crease. I'm going to be using this flat rounded concealer brush, and I'm just going to dip into my strobing palette, and I'm just going to cut my crease. Okay, and I'm just going halfway because we do have that darker outer corner, and I'm just going to set that with the big fluffy brush in the light white creamy color palette. Okay, and then I am going to go back in with this pink small brush and into that dark color again, and I'm just going to blend that together. Take this one again and just blend those colors together. And then just to neaten up my cut crease a bit, I'm going to go back into the flat angled brush, and I'm going to go into that nice, I'd say plummy color, and I'm just going to make these edges a bit neater and softer. Okay, I'm then going to go into this gold shimmer. The pigment is absolutely beautiful, and I'm just going to take my finger and I'm going to tap that into the middle of my eyelid. then I'm going to take this white also, and I'm just going to pat it more into the first corner, or the first third of my eye. Okay, I'm then going to do the other eye, and I will be back. Okay, so now both eyes are done. I'm now going to go in with my eyeliner. I'm going to be using the Essence Liquid Ink. And I'm just going to do a nice winged liner. And then you're going to do the other eye. It's funny, I've tried other liquid eyeliners, but I always tend to go back to this one. It is the most affordable, and I find that it is the most pigmented one that I've used from Essence. Okay, I'm then going to take the Long Lasting Eye Pencil from Essence, and I'm just going to go in my waterline. Okay, I'm then going to do my lower lash line, and I'm going to use, can find it, this little brushy over here, and I'm just gonna go in with the plummy red over here, and I'm just going to use that under my eye. Oh, these are so pigmented, they're really nice. And then I'm going to take another brush also for my underneath my eye, and I'm going to go into the darker purpley shade just to give it some definition. I'm just going halfway along my eye. Okay, I'm then going to go in with another brush. And I'm going to tell you exactly which one now when I find it. I'm just going to go in with this brush over here, and I'm just going to take some of the gold and some of that white, and I'm just going to go in the corner of my eye. Might even take my finger. Okay, you're then going to go in with mascara. As always, I'm using the Essence Princess Lash, and I'm just going to do a few coats of this. Okay guys, so this is the finished product. I hope you enjoyed this video, and yeah, please subscribe, give this video a thumbs up, and share the love. I hope you guys have a lovely weekend, and I'll see you next week. Bye.